Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. I hope we're all well and thank you very much for tuning in. The release of Sim Update 7 brought with it the hotly anticipated replay system to Microsoft Flight Simulator. Asobo decided they would release essentially what is an in-development version of the system that is in use by their video team to make their various trailers and other media. So it does come with its own instability issues, bugs, UX quirks, but with that being said, it does work quite well and it's nice to have something right there in the menus. With this early implementation of the system, the user interface and features it offers are not super self-explanatory, and you may find yourself scratching your head if you're used to replay tools from other sims. So in this first of a two-part video series, I'm going to show you how to use the basics of the tool so you can simply record part of a flight and play it back whilst being able to move and change the camera around as you wish. And in part two, which we'll release at a later date, we'll cover some of the more advanced functions of the tool, such as camera tracks, keyframing, and even moving the playback location of a sequence. This tool is actually surprisingly powerful. At the end of the video, I'll give you some of my own tips, observations, and I've got a little bit of feedback for Asobo. All right, let's get into it. First of all, let's take a look at how to actually enable the tool. I'll mention at this stage, in case you're unaware, at the time of making this video, the tool is currently only available for PC users and not Xbox, unfortunately. To enable the tool, first ensure you have not loaded into the world and are in the main menus. The following steps will not work otherwise. Next, we'll need to enable developer mode inside the sim. To do this, go to your options menu, then general options on the left hand side, click developers, and then enable the developer mode using the on-off toggle. Click apply and save at the bottom, and that enables the dev mode. Verify this has been enabled by moving your mouse to the top edge of the screen, and if done correctly, you will see a black menu bar. Then in this new menu bar, click options, and then close to the bottom underneath experimental, click enable replay panel. This will enable the replay mode and show an option for it alongside your ATC, fuel, weather panels, etc. when you are loaded into the world. Do not disable or exit developer mode as yet. This needs to remain enabled as we load into a flight. Okay, so let's get loaded in then and take a look at the basic functionality of the replay tool. Alright, so I'm loaded in, and before going any further, let's take a look at the panel itself and the parts of it we will be using in this video. You can close developer mode now if you want, by the way. Okay, so on the upper menu, you'll notice a new button here we can use. If you don't see this for whatever reason, click on the cog on the far right hand side and enable the replay option. Clicking this new button will show the interface for the replay tool. I'm going to throw up an image I grabbed from the official forums, which shows what each of the buttons' function is within the panel. Link to the thread I got it from is in this video's description. Now, we're not going to cover everything in this video, so I'll put a red box over anything not relevant. Feel free to pause and familiarize yourself with your options. Okay, so jumping back over to the sim then, in order to actually have something to replay, we need to tell the system to start recording. You'll already be used to this if you've used tools such as Flight Control Replay or Flight Recorder for the sim, but unlike X-Plane 11, for example, this tool unfortunately doesn't auto-record anything in the background. You must remember to start it recording. So to do this, just click the record button in the top left of the interface to start the recording, and the stop button immediately to the right of it to stop the recording. You can see me in the background recording a short clip extending the speed brake on the A320 and then playing that back as a demonstration. As one might expect, you can play back the replay, pause it once it's running, or stop it. You can even change the weather if you wish. Pausing the replay will keep the aircraft locked into the replay, so you'll not be able to control the aircraft or camera at all whilst the replay is paused. However, pressing the stop button will release the aircraft from the replay and you will regain normal control. You'll also notice there is a load and save feature in the tool. I won't go into that in too much detail here. That is pretty self-explanatory. And finally, at the bottom of the interface, you will see there is a show and hide UI button. This is basically just going to show and hide the normal UI for the sim. So for example, on external view, if you have the various gauges enabled, it will hide those, and it will also hide the white bar that appears at the top of the screen that you hover over to enable that menu there. Now, if you've played around with this tool already, you may have noticed that once you've started playback of your replay, you're no longer able to control the camera. And this is where the tool becomes a little unintuitive for someone wanting to just casually playback a replay sequence. So, why does this happen? The reason this happens is because when you record a replay, the sim is not only recording the location and trajectory of the aircraft, it is also recording your camera movements. It records this onto a camera track, which you can see denoted here in the interface by track 1. Note that track 1 is always going to be what was initially recorded when in flight. And thus, when you come to playback the replay, it is going to playback whatever camera track has been selected. In most cases, initially, it will be track 1. This is actually super powerful, and I can imagine some of the cool possibilities this opens up for creators. But for your average flight simmer, I don't think this is really what we wanted. So, how do we get around this then? Well, the solution is quite simple in practice, but in theory it is a little more complex. Once you've started playback of your replay, just hit the record button underneath camera track recording. This will then allow you to move the camera normally whilst the replay plays back, essentially giving you the power to record a new version of the camera movement part of your replay. Note that you cannot skip through your replay whilst the camera track is recording. If you want to skip to a specific part of your replay, you will need to stop the camera track recording first and then skip to the desired part of the replay and then click record under camera track recording again. When you start recording a new camera track, the replay tool will record your movements onto a new track, which you can either choose to playback. You can switch between your different cameras also during playback, or you can just start recording a new camera track again and have free movement of the camera. This final method is probably the way I will use the tool when just casually playing a sequence back, especially on stream. So you have a few options there, and hopefully that makes sense to you all. I haven't noticed any limit to the amount of camera tracks you can have, so this method is definitely viable for the casual user. And in this video, it is just a quick overview. There is obviously way more to this tool than that, but I think this is the basic functionality that we all expect from such a tool. And like I say, whilst it is actually super powerful for creators to be able to work with the camera in this way, I think Asobo does need to take another look at this and perhaps implement either a free camera track that can be used for casually playing back recorded flights, or potentially separate the camera track recording feature entirely. I would also like to see an auto record feature implemented or something to that effect, a bit like we have in X-Plane, so we don't have to remember to hit record every single time. Even with the tools we have currently, I forget very frequently to enable the recording when coming in for a landing or such like. A few other issues I would look out for whilst using the tool are: when playing back a replay, if you scrub very quickly on the timeline I have found it can quite easily crash the sim, so be careful with that. Recording a replay with multiplayer enabled can cause some pretty severe performance issues, especially in high density areas, and whilst it is cool that the tool does record other players in the area, I would recommend turning that off before trying this feature. Also, saving and loading a long replay can freeze up the sim for a while, but it should start responding after a while. And then finally, you will notice, and something that we are all pretty much used to at this moment in time, is that when playing back a replay of some aircraft, most notably third-party add-ons, you may notice the gauges, instruments, and other flight controls don't quite play back as they were in flight. And you may notice some sounds triggering that shouldn't as well. Hopefully this is something that will improve going into the future. Alright, so I hope that was useful to you and allows you to get started making replays in Microsoft Flight Simulator. If this did help you, please let me know by hitting the thumbs up button on this video. And if you don't want to miss part 2, make sure to subscribe to the channel. I'm happy to try and answer any questions you may have, so feel free to leave them down in the comments. Otherwise, I'll see you guys for part 2 of this tutorial. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a fantastic day. Bye-bye for now.